Okay, calculus 3, let's talk about what curvature is. Let me show you guys some graph first. Let's start with a circle, and then let's say the circle is traveling in the counterclockwise direction. And let's say I want to just put a point right here. And the question is, we'd like to know the curvature right here at this point. So what does that mean? Intuitively, you can just think about curvature is how much this is bending right here. And to really figure it out, we do this. Right here, we are going to draw a small tangent segment, and this right here is called the unit tangent factor. And I put down the arrow in the same direction as how the circle is traveling. And then right here, I will just do another one, right? And then again, put it here, and I'll do another one like this. So as you can see, all this right here, they pretty much have the same amount of bend, right? They kind of pretty much curve the same amount. And it's true that the curvature, we use kappa for the notation, of a circle, it depends on the radius. It's just 1 over a, where the a is the radius of the circle. So now you can imagine, if we have a smaller circle, the radius is small, the curvature will be bigger. So it's just like this. So you can feel a lot of bend right here. But if you have a much bigger circle, and if you're right here, if you're like, imagine you're just walking around a big circle, you don't really feel the turn, right? Yeah, just think about it like that. So just like if you go around the Earth, you feel like you are traveling a straight line, but Earth is rounded. Anyway though, so that's that. Now, that being said, what's the curvature of a line? You don't really have to do any computation here because you just have to ask yourself, does this bend? No. The curvature right here is equal to 0. Yeah? It does not bend, it's just straight lines. This line has slope, but that's calculus 1. The slope is just the first derivative. Curvature is how much it bends. It doesn't bend, so the curvature is 0. Now, for the last one, I would like to give you guys this right here. And this is meant to be e to the x. All right, let's look at this part right here. So if you just kind of create the small unit tangent factor, you can see that right here, we will have small curvature. Similarly, once we get up here, right, it does not really bend anymore, but the slope is big. The first derivative is big, but that, again, that's calc 1. Right here, this is also small curvature. So there will be one interesting question. It's like, where is going to give us the biggest curvature? Maybe somewhere here, right? So, biggest K, where do we get the maximum curvature? And I will solve this for you guys in another video, but this is a question for you guys to think about. Now, how do we calculate the curvature? So we will have to first have a smooth curve, meaning the curve is differentiable and all that good stuff. And let's just write it as r of t. And this right here can be in a 2D plane or 3D space. Then the curvature is defined to be, remember earlier, we need the unit tangent factor, and that is capital T. And it's a factor, and what we will do is take the derivative of that. But earlier, when I was going around, I would have to look at the amount of the arc lengths. So we take the derivative of this with respect to s. S is the arc lengths. And then if you don't want to have negative curvature, then at the end, you just apply the absolute value for it. So that's pretty much the definition. But unfortunately, this right here is not so useful because our function has t. This right here has s. So what do we do? Well, I will do that for you guys. Just do more math, of course. So have a look. We know curvature is equal to, we take the derivative of the unit tension factor, but I really don't want to do it with respect to s. I really want to do it with respect to little t. Let's just do it. With respect to little t. But of course, this is not the same as that. Don't worry. All we have to do is multiply by dt here and then divide it by the ds here. And this is legitimate because we are doing the chain rule. And then at the end, we still have the absolute value, right? The magnitude. Now just look at this as absolute value. The absolute value of a product, it's the same as the product of the absolute value. So we can do the following. Just take the magnitude of this thing and then times the magnitude of that. Now, this is very strange because whenever we take the derivative, we don't really have the d little t on the top. So let's fix that. And to do so, I will keep the first one as how d is. But for this, I will put the dt down. So we will get 1 over ds over dt like this. Okay? And then, let's see what do we get. We still have the dt over d little t in the absolute value for the magnitude. Now, what's this though? ds, ds is the arc length, just like the arc length here. That's my arrow here, by the way. You can find the curvature of this thing too. The arc length with respect to time, right? This right here gives you the speed. And the way we write speed is we find the magnitude of the velocity factor, right? The magnitude of the velocity factor. And then the absolute value on the outside doesn't really matter anymore because we have that right here already. So that's what we have. And at the end, I will just tell you guys, kappa is equal to, let's write it down this right here first, 1 over the magnitude of the velocity factor times the magnitude of the derivative of the unit tangent factor with respect to time. So this is what we are going to do for it. And let me just remind you guys, the unit tangent factor, to compute that, we look at the derivative of the r, which is just the velocity factor, and then we divide it by the magnitude of it. And then the factor v, this is just the velocity of the position. So all you have to do is take the derivative of r with respect to t. Huh?